We are going to use pig excrement and water to obtain free gas forever. Stay until the end of the video and you will discover how to build this device. Warning, handling gas is very dangerous. Always do so in an open area and be mindful of your surroundings. This is the diagram of the gas generating device. We will only use a polyvinyl chloride tank, a tap, and fittings. The whole system is designed to operate without electricity, using only natural biological processes. We are going to use a 150-liter polyvinyl chloride barrel with a hermetic closing lid. We will mark the area where we will make two holes, one at the bottom and another at the top. The hole at the top must be as high as possible, and the hole at the bottom must be as low as possible. We are going to use two bulkhead fittings like this to screw the accessories to the barrel. These fittings have rubber gaskets for complete water tightness. We must put one at the top and another at the bottom. We tighten the nuts well. Now we are going to drill a hole for the pressure relief valve. This valve holds up to 3 bars of pressure. If the gas pressure is too high, this valve will prevent the barrel from exploding by releasing the excess pressure. Here we have the elements that we are going to use to build our device. This tap will serve as a drain valve for our barrel. We put polytetrafluoroethylene tape on the thread of the tap to prevent leaks. Now we will prepare the quick coupling valve. We will also put polytetrafluoroethylene tape on all the threads to prevent gas leaks. It is very important to prevent gas leaks to avoid accidents. With this quick coupling valve, we will be able to quickly connect the gas extraction hose to our barrel. And here are the two pieces ready that we are going to install in the barrel. At the top, we fix the quick connection valve. And at the bottom, the waste drain tap. We put it tilted to one side to be able to connect a hose. Our barrel is ready to work. We put on the lid and we already have our device finished and ready to transport it to our country house. Now we have to find some organic waste to fill this barrel. The substrate that we are going to use is fresh pig feces, highly rich in easily degradable organic compounds. A single pig can generate more than 700 kilograms of feces per year. It is the equivalent of 17 kilograms of butane gas per pig per year. This would allow cooking for 70 to 100 hours, heating 600 liters of water, or replacing one bottle of butane. And that is with only one pig. We put the feces into the barrel. Yes, it smells very, very bad. What for some is waste, for us is clean energy. In some rural villages of China, India, and Nepal, toilets are directly connected to the biodigester. That is, human feces go directly to the system to generate gas. The biogas that is produced is then used to cook the food for the next day, closing an incredible cycle of use. We only fill up to 40 to 45% of the barrel. Now we add a little water to the manure, creating a semi-liquid mixture called slurry that favors bacterial activity. We will fill approximately 45% of the barrel with a mixture of 75% manure and 25% water. Now we are going to connect the drain valve with a hose that leads to a vegetable garden. The remaining liquid residue, known as digestate, is rich in nutrients and can be used as agricultural fertilizer once matured and treated. We close the barrel and make sure that there will be no gas leaks. Now we let the manure ferment for 2 weeks. Inside the barrel, in an oxygen-free environment, methanogenic bacteria begin to degrade the organic matter. This phase has a variable duration, but usually begins to produce gas between 3 and 7 days after the initial loading. The gas generated is composed mainly of methane, carbon dioxide, and traces of other gases. The methane content can reach up to 70%, which makes it highly combustible. After 2 weeks, we return to check the gas generated. We have this small portable gas stove. We connect it to the tank through the quick connection valve. You can hear the gas escaping due to the accumulated pressure. When recording with daylight, the flames can hardly be seen because it is a very clean fire. The gas generated is enough to boil a pot of water. Here the flames can be seen better. The flame, bluish in color, is indicative of a good proportion of methane gas. As we see, the gas generated serves perfectly for cooking. Now we are going to connect a blowtorch. As this blowtorch does not have a regulator, a large amount of gas comes out that generates a very visible flame. Do not even think about trying this indoors. You must always be very careful when handling gas and fire. By transforming livestock waste into useful energy, the environmental impact is significantly reduced. The uncontrolled emission of methane into the atmosphere is avoided, and the nutrient cycle is closed in a sustainable way. Let us know in the comments if you have implemented this system with different organic materials and your results. Let us take care of nature and use renewable energies. Thank you for watching the entire video. Please like and comment if you found this technology interesting. And if you want to support our videos, you can become a member to enjoy benefits and help our content grow. See you in the next video.